All right then. So let me just quickly start with the demo and as well as the introduction part. So myself, Shri guys. So based out in Amsterdam. So working as in logistics consultant. So I totally had almost like 18 years of experience coming to EWM, TM, and as well as the YL. So I worked in EWM for almost like 8 years, and then transportation management for four, and WM and YL. So it's completely logistics side. I was working from almost like 18 years all the way. So located back in Amsterdam here. So that's the my short, okay, coming back. So now coming back to this particular transportation management indeed, okay. So this transportation management indeed, we started it way back in the SEM. As a decentralized version. Now, in the latest versions, we are talking about the S/4HANA versions, but indeed it was started way back in SVM 8.0. So I started working in this transportation management from 9.3 version because it started from 8.0, 9.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the decentralized. And then we had it as an S4 as well. However, this is the current landscape. If you can see the architecture, what we had for any of the transportation managements. It is closely integrated with many of the modules in our SAP, with our EWM or maybe with the YL and the transportation. All these three ways having a very good combination indeed in coming to the scenarios or maybe to the business process as well. So that's different apart. So what we are going to see in this demo, what exactly the standard SAP TM is offering, and why do we require a transportation management, and why do we need to offer this to any of the customer solutions? So what exactly we are going to get it from the SAP transportation management, guys? The very first point. Now, just a general thing, guys. What is this transportation management indeed will do? Anyone, any idea? What does it offer? So what kind of a solution it's going to offer to the business?
Earlier, this transportation management was taken care by LETRA.
Exactly.
Now, going forward, since that SAP is stopping that support for LETRA in 2025, the
Exactly.
maximum companies will do this transportation management, right?
Yep. So what does this LETRA used to offer earlier?
Regarding the shipping and shipping cost, this
Exactly.
logistic related information.
It's all about your shipping and your shipping costs that you used to have it in LETRA functionalities, where we used to have your shippings and all. But when it is coming to this, this particular LETRA is going to stop in the 2025, as it was mentioned for the other warehouse management module also. And everyone, all the customers are bringing back to them to the S4 transportation management. So that is where it got started up. And most importantly, the advantages of getting this transportation management is, so we will have these kind of an advantages like the reduction of your transportation costs and the better communications with your suppliers and your vendors, either through your collaboration portal or through your logistics business network, and the better management of your bidding process and your tendering processes. Okay, so all these functionalities, because SAP transportation management in SAP, it's not only the solution what we have it in the market. There are many third-party solutions where they're offering the transportation solutions, like there are many third-party ones. But when it is coming to an SAP transportation management, why we need to insist to use this indeed? Yeah, because of the closely integrated with the other modules, as I said earlier, that this would be closely integrated with the many of our modules, from your sales to your procurement, and from your logistics execution point of view, for your warehousing and other stuff, and for your EHS, and for your GTS as well, and as well as for your event management. So all these things will be closely integrated, and also we will have an end-to-end overview of what exactly we are going to offer here. Okay, so that's the first thing that we are going to look after here. However, when we are trying to understand the basic scenarios of the transportation management, what it tries to offer for us from the SAP point of view. Okay, now when I'm talking about this particular transportation management, the current versions, what we had it ideally, because we are all from an SAP background, that's the reason I requested your background initially, because we know that these days everyone is talking a lot about an S4. So in this S4, we do have a different versions again. It started from 1710, followed by 1809, 1909, and by 2020 S4. And parallelly, we used to have the other landscape, which is also as called as a decentralized landscape, where we used to have your SAP with ERP 6.0 and 7.0 versions, and then coming with the decentralized one for SEM, where we used to have your EWM and TM in separate landscapes of an APO1, like 9.1, 9.2, 9.3. So indeed, both the functionalities remains the same. There are no major differences, but there are some kind of a changes. Indeed, both are happening in the systems. From the system point of view, yes, there are some changes, like in terms of creating your master data, or maybe in terms of sending your master data from one system to another system, or maybe in terms of creating your transactional data in one system to another system. Yes, there are some differences, but the core functionality of the transportation management remains the same. There is no change in that at all. Okay. Now, when I'm talking about this particular transportation processes, like as I said, that the current version, which what we had it in the market, is for the decentralized landscape, it is transportation management with 9.6 version, and 2020 is the latest one, not 1909. Okay. So these are the two things what we are going to have it in the market. So any questions or anything so far, guys, coming to the landscape wise so far?
Decentralized version means it is not
decentralized in the sense we would be having it in a two different systems, ERP in one system and TM in a different system. That's what I meant for the decentralized one. S4 in the sense you'll have your both ERP and your transportation management in the same instance. Okay.
Yeah, okay. I'm Lokesh Tom. You are well said. The thing is, you mean to say that is the embedded system.
Exactly. S4HANA, that's the embedded systems. The other one is your decentralized system. Okay. It, depending upon the client's landscape, we normally suggest, I mean, like at the time of the business point of view, we will suggest what is the best solution for the clients indeed. Okay. Because if the client is ideally using ERP from a long back, and we can propose them either the embedded TM of 1909 or 2020, or we can propose them the 9.6. It all depends upon the customer landscapes and all depends on the business decisions there. So we do have a two different models here. One coming with the decentralized, the other one coming with your embedded one, guys. That's what the current landscape of the transportation management is. Okay. Clear? All right. So yes. as we are providing the training in the S4 landscape, so probably I'll be focusing mostly on the S4 because that's the latest one. And indeed, I'll be showing you the differences of what we had it in. That's when we step into the sessions. I'll be showing you in one session that what are the differences we had it in the decentralized and how does it happens in the embedded also. However, now let me just focus on the embedded one. So that's what I'll try to help you out here. Now, before I start off with a normal processes over here, in the transportation management, we always talk about a four different pillars, guys. One about your order management, the other one about your transportation planning and tendering, and the other one about your freight execution and the monitoring and other stuff. But indeed, before I directly jump into the system or maybe the processes wise, this transportation management is offered for two different business scenarios. One is for your shipper scenario, the other one is for your LSP scenario. So on the whole, these are the two people where this transportation management would be implemented for. So a shipper in the sense, who could be a shipper? Any idea to anyone, guys, normally?
That client who is having his own transportation, right? Who is lending the trucks and the transportation to other? So he will be managing that his own.
Okay, that's another way. One. Okay, go ahead.
Who is actually sending the goods, dispatching the goods?
Mm-hmm. So who dispatches the goods indeed then?
Shipper scenario means like a DLF. And
courier service,
like courier
service. Okay, so there's a lot of difference here, guys. So let me just correct you over here. Okay. Now, if in case if you are talking about a shipper scenario, okay, normally a shipper is a person who would be having a kind of a manufacturing plant, or maybe he might be producing some kind of a raw finished products or whatever it is. Now he wants to send that finished products to one of its customers. Basically, that's where we require this transportation. Agreed, everyone?
Yes.
Yes.
So then that point of time, it's not in all the cases that shipper would be managing his own fleet. He would be giving the services to a third party, a person who is only managing his transportation. For example, I have a manufacturing firm like Nestle. So let's take it in that way. In Nestle, I do not need to worry about my transportation because I'll be just giving this transportation business to either to a DHL or either to a FedEx, or maybe to some other person who is giving me a best service in terms of cost and everything. So a shipper will be always a person who will be having a manufacturing plant and who will be sending the goods to his customer location, and where doesn't have any of its own fleet. So he will be the shipper, guys. Okay. Am I making it sense? Or maybe I'll put it in more granular level. In terms of system, for example, a customer who is already having an SAP systems like ECC or an embedded or whatever systems he is having, and if he is trying to implement a transportation management, he will be a shipper, because the shipper will always have a reference from either from a sales order or maybe from a purchase order. So a reference document would be created there, because when I say I'm sorry, someone is having some question, or am I good? Too good to go? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So in this way, a shipper is always a person who would be sending a goods to his customer, okay, and indeed who would be managing his own manufacturing plant and other things. And one second. Yeah, probably this would be okay. Yeah. So where he already had an SAP ECC system or something, or maybe an embedded systems. And in that point of view, we are trying to implement a transportation management for him. So those people will be a shipper, guys. Am I clear?
Sriram, what I understand means what from you. That means who having the own fleet, that person is going to implement.
Who is not having their own fleet? Who is having is a different concept. And for a person like who is having a own fleet, like a DHL or a FedEx, who is providing a services to us, those are the people we'll call them as an LSP. Those are the ones we'll call them as a logistic service providers. Okay. And shippers are the ones who will be supplying them to them. Okay. So it's another way around. Who has told me that shippers are the who is having own fleet? It's indeed not. Okay. Am I clear now?
Okay. That means I'm more clear. I need more clear.
So
what I am understand means the company have like Robert Bush or something.
Yeah.
The company produced some material. Yes, so exactly. That material I need to send it to customer. Okay.
Exactly. Yes.
So for that I'm using my own fleet or external fleet.
Exactly. If you're using an external fleet or your own fleet also, you will be a shipper in that case. Okay.
Yeah.
For example, let's take you being a Robert Bosch company, and you're supplying your and you have another company called Wipro. Let's assume that you are supplying your fleet to Wipro. Then you will be an LSP to Wipro, but Wipro will be a shipper for you. Okay.
Okay.
You got it?
That means
you are managing your own fleet for your own company, where you will behave as a shipper, and you are giving your fleet services to other companies also. So you are behaving as both as a shipper and also as an LSP scenario here. Okay.
Okay.
You got the point?
Yeah, I'm clear. Thank you.
So these are the two scenarios where we will be initially discussing on, guys. Okay, so that's where the transportation management will start. Because in both the scenarios, the functionalities will remain the same, but the terminology gets changed when we are talking about a forwarding houses, or maybe when you're talking about a forwarding orders, or maybe a forwarding settlements, or whatever it is. This all happens in case of your LSPs. But when we are talking about your shipper scenarios, we will be talking about your freight orders, or maybe your freight settlements, or maybe your freight units, or whatever it is. That terminology gets changed over here indeed. However, in both the LSP scenarios, or maybe in the shipper scenarios, okay, the most important thing we always need to recap here, guys, okay, is the concept. Okay, for example, so these are the four different pillars I was talking about earlier. So let's put this strategic freight management apart for the time being. So we can see here there are four different pillars in between, like an order management, a transportation planning, transportation execution, freight costing and settlement, and the reporting. So a TM will be holding up all these four, whether you take up an LSP or whether you take up an shipper. Am I clear now? So if you are able to understand these four pillars of the transportation management, that's what the SAP TM is offering for us, guys. Okay, when it is coming to the business processes wise, we will be having something called as an LSP, and we will be having something called as a shippers. And both the LSPs and both the shippers, whatever it is, has to follow these four different pillars in the transportation management. Am I clear, everyone? Hello?
Yes.
Yes. Now, now let me come to the first point, which is of a shipper scenario. Now let's take a company called the Robert Bosch that one gentleman has referred. So a Robert Bosch, what they do, they might produce a same material. Maybe they do a kind of a repetitive manufacturing, that the same material would be produced for longer periods, or maybe they might produce some kind of any of the Bosch materials, whatever it is. So we have to send it, that products, to multiple places. Means throughout in India, or maybe throughout the world, or wherever it is, we need to send this to the multiple customers indeed, because your customers might place it in Germany, or maybe in Amsterdam, or maybe in US, or maybe in India as well, right? So in order to send the products to the customer, what is the reference document that we initially start off? Because how do we know that a customer has requested a product from a Robert Bosch? How do we know that? That is where
purchase order.
Exactly. That is where this order management comes into the picture. Whether you do it through a purchase order, because purchase order in the sense what you're trying to do, you're trying to procure, because in order to do a finished product, you need to procure some kind of a raw materials for that. So either you do a purchase order or either you do a sales order, because when you want to send out a goods to some of your customers, okay, so basically you're selling your products indeed, right? So in ideally, what are we trying to do in this order management? We ideally look after of multiple things, like what? Your purchasing related orders, or your maybe your stock sales order related ones, or maybe your STO ones. So all this kind of an order management will be needs to be integrated to your transportation management, such that your transportation management will be linked for these all these particular orders. Am I clear? First point?
Yes. Both inbound and outbound logistics.
Obviously, because inbound is the one where you want to receive the goods inside your warehouse, and outbound is the one where you want to ship out the goods from your warehouse. Then what would be a reference documents for them? So you should have an inbound delivery or an outbound delivery for that, right? So in order to have this, basically an order management integration is required to your transportation. This is where the base gets, I mean, like the base transportation model gets started, and this is applicable only for your shipper scenarios. Why? Because when I'm talking about an LSP, let's assume that I being a customer, I want to move some products from India to Netherlands. I want to bring some kind of my household goods, something like that. So I approached one of the logistics service providers like FedEx. Sorry. Or maybe a DHL, or maybe a Canonical, or any of the logistic service providers, I've approached them. So normally, how do I approach them, guys? Anyone? God. normally how do we approach them? Tell me.
Maybe we'll ask them for a quotation first.
Now, for the LMD orders, what? We need to raise the purchase order for that because this is external. So we have to raise the purchase order.
I'm just a normal customer and I'm just going to a DHL or a FedEx office. Why would I raise a purchase order to them? I will raise a quotation to them, right, initially.
And next step is a sales order or
LSP scenario, you will not have any reference to your all these documents, guys. So basically what happens is we will raise a quotation from a FedEx or a Canonical or whoever it is, then they will send you this prices. Maybe FedEx will be charging you somewhere around 200 to 300 euros and DHL will charge you only 250 euros. And DTDC or something may charge you somewhere around 150 euros. So what would be your preference here then? Who is the cheapest one, right? So based on that quotation, what we generally do there, we will just proceed with the forwarding order there indeed. Okay. So that is what an LSP will be performing it. Okay. In an LSP scenarios, we will not have any of the reference of documents such as your purchase orders or your sales orders or maybe anything of that. Clear? Hello?
Yes.
Yep. So, however, we'll directly create something of a forwarding orders or something, and then we will proceed further. That's a different case in the LSPs. But let's first talk about a shipper here. In this particular shipper, the very first thing is about a order management, like where we will integrate your sales or your purchases or your stock transport orders or your inbound deliveries or your outbound deliveries. All kind of a delivery integration will be done here. That is what an order management is, guys. First point. Am I clear?
Yes.
Okay. Now coming to the transportation planning, guys. Means what does this mean by a planning here? Can someone tell me? What do you mean by a planning and what kind of a planning we do here normally?
Normally in the transport TU, we will assign what is the orders it is there, what is the size. And if it is a third party LMD partner, means we'll even tell the size and weight also to them.
Means a planning in a sense, a simple example, guys, in a real time example. Normally,
it will involve packaging and all unit handling.
Let it be. So, normally, what
vehicle is main important. First thing is vehicle. What vehicle we are going to plan. Then what the locations, from two locations, then which is the status to route.
All right. So let me, is it all, guys? Can I proceed now?
Yep.
So a simple example, guys. Now, for example, let's assume that you're traveling somewhere to, maybe to Germany or somewhere. So what normally you do? Firstly, let's take a real-time simple example. Normally what we do from your home, if you want to go to Germany or maybe to US or to some any of maybe to Dubai, what we generally do? Can someone tell me?
We'll book ticket first.
First point. Okay. Next. That's it. That's what we do. We don't do anything apart from that.
Travel. What stages?
We will pack our things.
Yes.
Required for travel.
Exactly. We will pack our luggage and then we will move. Okay. Next, tell me how many. That's what. See, this is what we have to correlate now. Go ahead.
From home to airport, how I'm going to travel.
Exactly. From your airport to your airport, how are you going to travel? That's one thing. And from an airport to your destination location, to an Abu Dhabi or maybe to Schiphol Airport or maybe to. So how you are traveling it? That is one thing. And from the destination airport, your customer location. So ideally, if you see this, guys, normally what is going to happen here? The very first thing is a planning is much more required here, right? Why? Because you need to plan in such a way that how many persons are traveling here? It is one person or two persons or four persons or five persons or seven persons. Because based on that planning from your home to your airport, normally you would go by your own car, and if it is a group of 10 people, normally what you do, you try to book a bigger cab, like a big size of a cab, so that you will do a planning for that Indian, right? Because you need to see your luggage and everything. So even when we come to the real time also, guys, when we are doing some kind of a planning, means what kind of a planning we would require here. So that is where we come into the picture, like the mode of transportation and the means of transportation. How are we sending the goods from one place to another place? What kind of a vehicle was that? Or we require a full container or less than container load or a full container load, or maybe a less than truck load or a full truck load. How much of the weight we required for this? And in order to move from one place to another place, who is the carrier? In our case, we can contact an Uber or maybe an Ola or in whoever it is. In the real time, we might contact a FedEx or maybe to a DHL or maybe to some other persons. Who is giving you the cost effective one? So these are all the things will come into the picture when we are talking about your planning, guys. Okay. And how do you want to have this planning needs to be happen when you're integrating this to your EWM systems, when you're doing some kind of a cartonization planning, or maybe when you're doing some kind of a dock appointment schedulings, how are you loading your trucks and what way you would like to load your packages inside your truck? Okay. So this is all the planning would be important at this stage, guys. That is what, in a nutshell, I can say that a planning is the most important thing in the transportation management one, because this is the place where you decide on what kind of a vehicle and what kind of a resource you would require and what kind of a means of transport. All kind of a planning would be done in this stage, guys. Am I clear?
Yes.
This is where the planning would be required for us. As simple as that. Okay. I'm just trying to give you a high level overview, because I'm not getting into the technical details out of each and everything, because there are a lot of things in each and everything, because I'm not trying to put those details as of now here. Okay. I'm clear. So that is where the planning would be required. And the next thing, the execution means, I would like to know, for example, execution will come into the picture, guys. For instance, let's do in this way. Whenever we are having any kind of packages that you have ordered from an Amazon or maybe from an DHL or wherever it is, okay, what do you generally do it? Okay, normally we will try to track the shipment status, right? Because it might say that, okay, the package was packed and it reached to some kind of an hub, and from hub it is reaching to some other place, and from that place you would be reaching to your place. So this is a kind of an execution or maybe a kind of a tracking that you would be required here. Agreed, everyone? So that is what the execution comes into the picture, guys. Means the visibility of your full end-to-end process of your shipments, okay? And we will be integrating with your EWM, and we'll be integrating with your event management here to have an end-to-end tracking of your particular business. You got it, everyone? That is what this flight execution and the monitoring comes into the picture, where the system will try to have a real-time updates, like maybe it was departed, or maybe it was loading was started, loading has ended, and it reached to the destination hub, or it reached to the source. All these kind of events or everything will be done through this flight execution and as well as through the monitoring as well. I hope that's clear now. Okay. Now, coming to the last one, the fourth important pillar, guys. In the transportation management, always remember the planning and the flight settlement and costing. These two are the most important things, guys. Just remember that. Okay. Now, when I'm talking about the costing, what kind of a costing it comes into the picture? Can someone help me? Guys?
What type of BL charges,
freight cost, basically. Yeah.
Exactly. That's a freight cost. Means we made use of some transportation services, and obviously we need to pay for them, right? Because even when you're transporting, when you're going in a cab, basically what you do, we generally move it, we'll pay it after once you reach the destination. How does that happen? Basically, right? That is where this particular freight costing and the settlement means. If you are traveling from one place to another place, for example, this particular charges would apply. For example, 1,000 rupees INR or maybe 2,000 when you're traveling from one place to another place. That depends upon your fuel, your surcharge, or whatever it is, guys. It all comes into the picture. Based on that, what we are trying to do here, we are trying to charge to the customers, indeed, right? And upon we do this, we will have to settle it, because in the transportation management, we need to send it for the invoice verifications. So this kind of an information, whatever is there, that is what this freight costing and the settlement will come into the picture. Am I clear, everyone? Hello? Yes?
Yes, Sridhar.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, this is what we have, this one, okay? The four different pillars, guys, okay? Any other questions now so far, guys?
Yeah, we can move on. Sure, I'm clear with this.
All right then. Okay. All right. So in order to have these four different pillars to fulfill, this is where our this transportation management is coming into the picture to fulfill all these kind of gaps. Okay, in the whether if you want to do it from an SAP transportation management, whether how do you want to have your orders to be integrated and how do you want to have your shipments moved from one place to another place. So all these kind of an information can be captured over here, guys. The very first thing. Okay, so. And the same way, when we are talking about this particular one regarding the logistics service providers, we indeed do the same thing. But instead of the order management, we will directly create a quotation. And from the quotation, we will create a forwarding order. And from the forwarding order, we will start doing the same things. Like your transportation planning, even they require some kind of a planning because LSPs also do that. And then they also need a transportation execution followed by the freight settlement and this. So if we were able to understand the four different pillars of the transportation management, what we had, this is what indeed the TM, guys. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead, please.
I need to ask the things. This slide is going to end, or we are continuing with some other part, like how the forwarding order will work, how the freight order will work.
That is
that scenario we are going to discuss.
In each, because now when I'm talking about this planning, no, here we are trying to create something called as your freight orders or the freight units. So basically, this is something where we we discuss how you want to create your freight units indeed. Whether you want to have a full truck or a less than truck load, or on what basis the rules, because you might also move the goods. For example, you would like to have in your business, maybe let's assume that you're working on some agri business, guys. Okay, some agriculture business, something. And in those industries, normally when you are trying to ship the goods from one place to another place, generally what we do is we will try to have the scenario in such a way that you cannot club all the materials away, because you might have a pesticides in one. In a sales order, you might end up having a multiple things like your pesticides or maybe your products, which is for the animal food or maybe for other things and all. So based upon the incompatibilities or based upon the product attributes, normally we will try to separate them in the planning, and then we will try to create a different freight units for each and everything. That's how we will have one different truck for one kind of products. and another truck for a different. This is all the planning where we do it in your freight units or maybe in your freight order level. So this kind of a planning would be required there. Okay. So that is what we do it. Even in your forwarding orders also, we will be doing the same kind of stuff. However, there we will have with the reference of a forwarding order, not with reference of your sales or maybe with your purchasing one. Okay. Clear, guys, everyone? Hello?
Yeah, I'm clear, Steve.
So this is all then a kind of a high level overview that we would be having it. And once we jump into the sessions, normally we will be having an in detail of each and everything, how we will be integrating and how we'll be creating the master data. Because normally once we start doing it, because we normally do it from a scratch, like we will create our own organizations and we will create our own sales data and everything. And then we'll try to implement that in the system. And from there, we will take it ahead, actually. Okay. Hello, am I there?
Yes, yes.
Well,
yes, sir.
So any questions, yes, to me on this part? Anyone, guys?
No, sir. Not now.
All right, then. So basically, this is how we would be we will be having our sessions, guys. Normally maybe you can get the content from Suresh. He would be sharing you the content for that. However, if you are having any questions, you can just put it across to me now. Anyone?
Actually, Sriram, this transport management, it is there, na? So it is what is the mandatory integration? It should be there. I mean, I know ERP you are telling, like logistic execution also we can integrate, and EWM also you can you are telling that we can integrate this TM system, na?
Mm-hmm.
So what are the possibilities? I mean, for the TM, I can connect it. One is from SD. I'm asking about the integration. I know from EWM to TM integration, it is available. Mm-hmm. So.
What
so how you are connecting with the ERP, I'm telling.
Normally for a decentralized one, we will connect it through an PI or an XI. Okay. But in the these embedded systems, there is no PI interface is required. Okay. You got it?
Okay.
Yeah. So you're talking about the integration between your EWM to your, I'm sorry, from your TM to your ERP systems. You mean to say that?
Correct. ERP and EWM also. It is mandatory of EWM is mandatory for TM. Otherwise, it is not required.
It is not mandatory. That's an additional component. It is not a mandatory, right?
So from logistic, if it is not there, means logistic execution system to the TM system, and we'll do it.
Exactly. So when you talk about the systems integration, we had a multiple ways of getting the system integrated here. From the EWM point of view, I know you're talking about the QRSCs, but from a TM point of view, we would have something like an PI or an XI interface if it is a decentralized one. But in the embedded one landscapes, we also do not require that indeed. Okay.
Okay.
Yep. Example
I'm audible. Please go ahead.
Yeah, Sriram, Alok here. Like in the previous thing, there were queues, right? So for a decentralized system, we have a queue system. Is the queue system still there for
queue system? The EWM, it is a different way. And from the transportation management, it would be in a different way. Why? Because here we would be referring to a different transactions like SRT underscore money or something like that. And we will be just the failed ones. Okay. Like it's a kind of a queue system only again. Okay, but we will not
because for decentralized, I think there were queues, right? Inbound queues, outbound queues. We need to monitor those every time. In the
sense, you would be monitoring your messages, your PI and your XI messages.
Safe models like
Only required only when you're doing your master data. But how about your transactional data? So in the transactional level data, you will be just requiring the same thing. Like you would be referring to the PI or XI messages there. Okay.
Okay, so same thing is there over here in S4HANA as well, or like there is a separate
transaction. That's what I'm trying to say. In SRT underscore money, we'll be doing that. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Got it. Yeah.
Any other questions, guys?
Yes,
Yeah, what is the prerequisite module? I mean, which is better to have?
You mean to say prerequisite module in the sense? No, I didn't get your question.
I'm basically from SD background. So which module will have more advantage of learning DM? Is it EWM or SD or MM or any?
So ideally, EWM is a different thing again. That's all about your warehouse operations, and transportation is completely different. Both are having its own individual advantages. Okay, when we compare with an SD or an MM, EWM and DM are equally having a good opportunities there. Okay, now EWM is quite matured product now comparing to TM, because TM is still it's in the stable. It's not yet that stable indeed, but EWM is a quite matured product now even. So you will be having a good opportunities even for both EWM and as well as in the TM. That's not at all a problem.
So from, for an SD consultant,
transportation management would be a better one.
Yeah, that's what I'm asking.
Yeah.
Okay.
And hello.
Yes, please. I can. Can you be a bit loud? Your voice is too low for me.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can too. Please go ahead.
Hello. This how a TM is integrated with SD. Just can you give me just elaboration, please?
Integration in the sense, what kind of an integration you are looking out for? That's what, right? So integration in the sense.
No, earlier.
Go ahead. Go ahead. Earlier.
Earlier, you said that there would be two different systems would be there, right? Like TM is working on a different system and. S4 would be a different system, and there would be just both would be embedded together, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, like how SD or any other model will get integrated with this TM model?
I mean, that's where your order management is playing the major role, right? Because you're integrating through your order management, and that's how the TM integration will be happening for you, okay? So, before we do that, we need to integrate it. Ideally, what you mean to say, what you mean to say, that is how this is getting integrated with your SD or with your MM, right? That's what your question,
right?
Yeah. So in that case,
right.
Yeah, that is what. In that case, that's where this order integration will come into your picture. That's what I mean to say. Okay. Clear? All right, any other questions to me, guys?
Sriram, it is like whether we have the TM, whether there is two different type, like basic TM and advanced TM, is that anything like that?
Exactly. We do have two different types of things ideally. Like one would be a basic, because when we are dealing with an S4 landscape, it depends upon the customer's billing and depends upon the customer's what do you call the thing. We do have two different things, like basic and as well as an advanced. In the basic one, we will only have a few kind of functionalities. Like you do not have like the transportation cockpit, and you do not have your optimizer, and you do not have your carrier selections, and you do not have your EWM integrations. So all these kind of features are not available in the basic TM. I did have that in my presentation, but I didn't provide you that information because I thought I can give you this information later part. So this is what the basic shipping. But if you're doing with an advanced one, if you see this, that where you'll have all kind of a functionalities, like you will be integrating with your event management or your extended warehouse management. So all kind of the functionalities would be available here. So, but however, the costing wise, it will be too high for the advanced one, what SAP will be charging. And for the basic, it's already, it's a kind of a package that you'll be getting it. Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
But we will be looking on this advanced, right? Advanced.
Yes, we'll be looking at these advanced functionalities only. Like we'll be talking about your cockpit and your carrier selection, and then we'll be having all these functionalities. Where in the basic, we will not have these things. Okay.
Okay.
Yep. So any questions, guys? because it's being a demo. I'm just trying to put it in a very high level, what in transportation management is offering. So once we step into the sessions betterly, then I can just deep dive into more into the technical details.
Yeah, Shriram, one question. Are we going to check with the migration part? Like, suppose it is in, currently it is a system is in decentralized one and they want to get into S4HANA embedded one.
Migration,
so in that case,
part is not a part of this content, but indeed we are only just focusing on the standard e-transportation management, what it is offering at least. Mm-hmm. But migration, okay. We are not covering it here.
Okay. Fine.
All right then. Any other questions, guys?
And about like sometimes they are having some LETRA, and if they want to move to TM, that conversion we will be covering in this.
What kind of a conversion you mean?
Like now this client is having some LETRA module, so they will be having some routes and everything. When we are moving to TM, that will be like locate. They will be converting it to location like this. This conversion will be covered.
That conversion, anyhow, yeah, I can take you to that. That's not a problem. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. So anything, guys? If not, you can just leave your feedback to Suresh, and then you can let me know. Okay. All right then.
Thank you.
All right, Bill. Guys, thank you. Thank you, and have a good day.
Thank you. Thank you, Suresh. Thank you.
Yeah.